Hello, Julia. Do you remember a few years ago I was with you at this event and I said, I wish Julia would be recognised for everything she's done for so many years and for so many people she's helped. And tonight it's happened, all thanks to me. Actually, it's not me, it's you. You have done so many great things in your life. You've helped so many people. And I am delighted, finally, that you are going to be given the Variety 2016 Humanitarian Award. I wish I was there, but no one invited me. Love you lots and enjoy the night. It's very much well deserved, Julia. Love you. Bye-bye.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to meet all of the Miss Worlds that we have with us this evening. But first, let's look back and see when they were crowned.
Spain!
The reigning Miss World, Maria Calaguna.
Philippines!
Miss World 2013, Megan Young.
Republic of China.
Please give a warm welcome from China, Yuwen Chang. From the United States of America, Alexandra Mills.
Russia.
From 2008, from Russia, it's Xenia Sukinova.
Turkey.
From 2002, from Turkey, Azra Akin.
Miss Nigeria.
From 2001, it's Agbani Darigo.
1993 is Miss Jamaica.
The ever beautiful Lisa Hanna. Miss World 1980, Kimberly Santos. And ladies and gentlemen, Miss World 1953, Denise Perrier.
The definition of a humanitarian is one who, through aid and action, saves lives, alleviates suffering, protects human dignity, and advances social reform. Every year since 1939, Variety has bestowed our Humanitarian Award on deserving individuals who have made a contribution to make the world a better place. The Humanitarian Award is acknowledged to be one of the highest honors bestowed on an individual. And Variety International is privileged and proud to pay homage to the many distinguished men and women who have made a difference over the years. Past recipients include Reverend E.J. Flanagan, Sir Alexander Fleming, Sir Winston Churchill, Dr. Albert Schweitzer, His Royal Highness Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh, Bob Hope, Earl Mountbatten of Burma, Sir William Butlin, Leonard Cheshire and Sue Ryder, Frank Sinatra, Monty Hall, Dame Vera Lynn, Her Royal Highness Princess Anne, Sammy Davis Jr., Audrey Hepburn, Sir Edmund Hillary, Sir Roger Moore, Jerry Lewis, Buzz Aldrin, Simon Cowell, the Coca-Cola Company, and this year's recipient of the Humanitarian Award, Julia Morley.
Please welcome your hosts for this evening, Angela Chow and Miss World 2013, Megan Young.
Wow, I heard we had the most beautiful crowd here tonight in Jersey. How are you guys feeling? How's Jersey? We like to get you guys rocking earlier on. Okay, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this very special evening as Variety International presents its 75th Humanitarian Award here at the Royal Showground in Jersey. We would like to welcome all our guests from all over the world to celebrate the achievements of our honorary awardee, Miss Julia Morley. We're shortly going to invite Julia onto the stage to share with us a lifetime of memories. But first, let's see why Julia is being honored tonight.
Miss World is undoubtedly one of the most iconic shows on television, having been broadcast to billions of viewers over its 64-year run. Originally started by Eric Morley in 1951, the show has featured A-list celebrities and stars by their dozen. Many previous Miss Worlds have gone on to become global icons, but one icon stands head and shoulders above the rest. And this year, it's time to stop and pay respect to the driving force behind Miss World, Julia Morley. There's just something about Julia that's so sincere. Her energy to inspire people and to make people go out of their ways to get involved in these things with her is just incredible.
We call her Gem, and I don't think there's anyone who reflects light as much as that woman.
Julia has been a familiar face on Miss World, having been involved since 1965. Having never been one to rest on her laurels, Julia transformed the competition when she started Beauty with a Purpose in 1972.
Unbelievable what this woman has accomplished.
This has now become the heart and soul of the competition, changing it from just being a beauty pageant to a force for good in worldwide causes.
Nelson Mandela therefore salutes the Beauty with a Purpose program.
When Julia Morley came up with Beauty with a Purpose, what a purpose it's been.
I know she's raised over £500 million, billion, not million, pounds for children.
I think there's a certain irony, I have to say, that I'm standing accepting this award while Julia's standing here, because genuinely, I think you actually should be getting this award, not me.
What a job is being done by the Miss World organization. Kudos.
After the untimely death of Eric Morley, Julia took over the reins of the company and has driven it forward to become the entertainment and charitable success it is today.
Julia Morley is a real woman of the world, and she is making things happen all over the world.
She's just an inspiration. She fights for all that's beautiful, good, and true.
Anyone who's ever met her has nothing but love and admiration for her.
While many believe Miss World is simply a beauty pageant, if you look beneath the surface, it's obvious that it's anything but.
I've had the privilege of working alongside Mrs. Julia Morley as she traveled the world in support of these children. She's truly an angel on earth.
The true essence of Miss World and beauty with a purpose. Today we salute you, Julia Morley.
Ladies and gentlemen, accompanied by Bradley Walsh, please welcome our honoree, Mrs. Julia Morley.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's see what Beauty with a Purpose is all about.
First created in 1971, Beauty with a Purpose is Julia Morley's legacy. It sits firmly at the very heart of Miss World, a charity that has lasted over 45 years and has raised hundreds of millions of pounds for disadvantaged children worldwide. This, however, is no ordinary charity. Beauty with a Purpose has immense depth and uses a multifaceted approach in helping its many worthy causes. The secret lies in the economies of scale. Each and every year, Miss World adds an extra 130 contestants from across the globe to the Beauty with a Purpose family, all running their own charity for their respective causes.
Wherever we go in the world, it enables us to raise more money for more causes.
Beauty with a Purpose commits itself annually to many charities across the globe. It identifies problems, creates a solution, and either fundraises or finances the operation.
Being able to change people's lives is such a beautiful thing.
Take, for example, the ongoing projects to supply clean drinking water to the citizens of Pastel, Haiti.
She's the spearhead of this all. I mean, she pours her heart into what she does with Beauty with a Purpose.
The leprosy project in Brazil, the anti-jiggers campaign in Kenya, fundraising for cleft palate teams in Africa, South America, Sri Lanka, and Russia, fundraising tours to support abandoned and neglected children in Vietnam, long-term support for both Operation Hunger and the Nelson Mandela Foundation in Africa. Another facet of Beauty with a Purpose involves fundraising and finance, where it works closely with charitable organizations in a drive to raise awareness and much-needed money for specific causes.
The most gratifying part of the exercise was when I was able to hand over a check for $300,000 from the fund to the Jamaica Red Cross Society.
Ladies and gentlemen, last year I recognized Hong Kong because they raised, over those years, $383 million.
2007 in Beijing, China. $5.5 million was raised for the International Red Cross. And in 2008, over $7 million was raised in Vietnam for abandoned and neglected children.
Beauty with a Purpose has literally saved thousands of lives and empowered young people.
And the final facet of Beauty with a Purpose is in support for its partner charities. This could be as simple as turning up to lend a helping hand and create a presence, or a consolidated approach to helping out a worthy cause, such as the Variety International Telethons, or traveling with Variety International to all parts of the globe.
I am here today with other members of the Variety International Fund to make a difference,
supporting their efforts as a consolidated team.
The children are all so friendly, and yet it's obvious that they need additional help and care, and we're gonna do what we can to help them.
Every child is entitled to an opportunity to live, to love, to laugh, to be secure.
It's been my honor since 1971, when I introduced Beauty with a Purpose, to realize that every parent, every girl, over that many years, is now still involved with me across the world.
Nelson Mandela salutes the Beauty with a Purpose program, which helps children worldwide and which also mobilizes young people to be involved in their own country with a useful purpose to assist disadvantaged children.
This gives tens of thousands of young women every year the opportunity to make a real and lasting contribution to the lives of the sick and disadvantaged.
It's not just about wearing a crown, it's about what you use this crown to do. And for me, the most important thing is to impact on those who are less fortunate in society.
This three-tiered approach makes Beauty with a Purpose unique in helping the disadvantaged global population today.
Priyadarshini Academy would like to recognize Miss Morley's outstanding humanitarian contribution to help children in over 100 countries lead a better life.
Julia Morley is the heart and soul of this charity, and her strength, determination, and drive is unparalleled in her humanitarian pursuit for the betterment of children's lives across the planet. As you can see, this is the magic that Julia Morley brings with her as she globetrots right across this world. And as you can see, Beauty with a Purpose does work on multi-levels in every country that she goes into. And we're going to start with UK right now. We're going to go visit a school called the Brent Knoll School. If you know it, well, we're going to see something that's going to surprise you.
Congratulations on your fantastic achievement. The whole of Brent Knoll School is celebrating with you tonight. When we heard about your achievement and the award, we thought, what's the best way of celebrating with Julia and marking what a fantastic occasion this is? And we thought, music. Our children have been working really hard on learning the songs. It's one thing learning a new song, but learning a new sign with it is something else. So for you, Julia, here is the Brent Knoll Big Sing and Sign. This is our brand new school, a building we are so proud of, a dream that's finally been realised. So let's go and have a look inside.
We can meet them just for one day. Julia's our hero, just for one day. Julia's our hero, just for one day.
We want to plant the garden with plants that have textures, with smells, with scents. We're looking to develop the central courtyard area of the school. Things like mirror walls and chime bars that children can interact with. Everybody knows all the fantastic work you've done around the world, which makes it even more humbling for us that you took an interest in our local special school here in Lewisham.
Honesty, I wanna see you be brave.
You were there for us when we needed a minibus, and you're still there for us now. So we'd like to thank you for that and wish you all the very best and a fantastic evening.
Beside me, the very proud headmaster, Jonathan Sharp. The kids, they're amazing, but how long did it take them to get ready for that?
That was a few weeks practice, I've got to be honest with you, Angela, but we had really good fun putting that together. Brent Knoll's a school, a specialist school for children with autism, and our children are profoundly affected in terms of communication. And one of the things we try and do is give them the confidence to communicate, through singing and signing as well. So not only were they learning a new song, but they were learning signs as well. So that was the culmination of a few weeks' work, I have to say. But it was well worth it. We really enjoyed putting it together for Julia.
I think they were amazing. And the emotions and the excitement that they... I think they got so much more for it from themselves as well.
Absolutely. We've been really, really fortunate in that we've had 4 years' relationship with Julia and Beauty with a Purpose. And the kids just love seeing our visitors and the impact that the work of Julia and Beautiful with Purpose has. And as I say, it's amazing that despite all the global work that Julia does on a humanitarian level, that she still has time for a small special school like us in London. It's fantastic.
Well, go on, blow her a kiss. She's just right there, Jonathan.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Did you love the song, Julia? Did you love it? And Beauty with a Purpose not only works and supports these projects, but so many more in towns all across the UK. Take a look.
Every year, I circulate Julia Morley's Beauty with a Purpose message as a fundraising pack, which actively encourages every contestant in our area heats to raise awareness and funds and do something positive in their area for Beauty with a Purpose. It's fantastic to see how much the girls take this on board. They work so hard and raise lots of money using the Miss World Beauty with a Purpose slogan. We've managed to raise and fund projects around England, such as specially adapted coaches and wheelchairs for disabled children, a wonderful holiday home in Torquay for disadvantaged families, £50,000 for Corum, England's oldest children's charity, life-saving hospital equipment, and we're currently funding a sensory room for a school for autistic children and adults with learning difficulties at Landmarks College, which is an ongoing project. We always use the Beauty with a Purpose slogan around the country at many of our Miss England heats, with over £1 million that's been raised by Miss England in the last few years. And without Julia, this would not have been possible. Thank you for being such an awesome woman, Julia Morley. You've encouraged so many people to do so many different things, and I'm one of them.
Please welcome on stage Miss England Natasha Hemmings, Miss Wales Fionn Moyle, and Miss Scotland Marie Heath Ferguson. All right, ladies, you guys have been doing so much charity work. So, Miss England, how much money have you guys raised so far?
I am so proud to announce that with all the help of the Miss England contestants, we have raised over £1 million for Beauty with a Purpose.
That is incredible. And Miss Wales, how is all the charity work going so far?
We have worked really hard and have raised over £600,000.
This is such an amazing feat. And Miss Scotland, I know that you have all just started with Beauty with a Purpose, but what is the update with that so far?
Through Beauty with a Purpose in the past year, we've managed to raise over £185,000.
These ladies deserve more than just a round of applause, and it is an unbelievable amount of money, but it's so fantastic to see what is happening around the UK. Thank you so much, ladies.
You know, from Ireland, Krish Naidu was Julia Morley's first appointed Beauty with a Purpose worldwide ambassador, an exceptional man and close friend of Julia. Sadly, Krish passed away recently. He had planned to be here this evening to pay a very special tribute to Julia. However, in his absence, his son, Krishna Naidu, wanted to be here with his mother to deliver his father's words. A round of applause, please.
Thank you. Before he passed away, my father was working on a tribute to you, Julia, for this very night. So in my father's words, Miss World pageant has the motto, Beauty with a Purpose. Julia wants Miss World and all the national title holders to understand the title should be used to benefit underprivileged and disabled children, regardless of race, color, or creed. Julia devoted her life to this end. Her energy and enthusiasm is an example to not only Miss World contestants, but to all of us. We congratulate you, Julia. My father was very proud to be part of Beauty with a Purpose, and us as a family will continue that support. Thank you, Julia.
Very, very touching words. As many of us knew Krish very, very well, and he really put his heart into it. I think it all began with Julia. And next to me, a man, especially emotional for him as well, hearing these words. From Ireland, we go to Malaysia. This is Mr. Kenneth Lee. Can you tell us your story?
Yes, and Lee. Firstly, Julia, it's really good to see you. The association that my father had with Miss World and Julia goes back almost 5 decades when he became the country licensee for Malaysia all those years ago. And the imprint of Miss World's work for charitable causes was very clear in the work that my father did. And none more so than demonstrated when he worked with a close friend. And Julia, you'll remember him, Tan Sri Jeyaretnam. Yes, absolutely. They started what was then a fledgling foundation. It was a little ramshackle wooden house with only a few children. They called it the Sultan Idris Shah Foundation, named after a sultan in Malaysia. And here you see Tan Sri Jeyaretnam and Julia. And that was the state and condition in which the early foundation was. But you will see in one of the other photographs, with the seed money that they raised, and that was how it was a little later, this is what it is today. Incredible. The facility is a community-based rehabilitation center serving the physical needs of disabled children in the state of Perak. And from its very humble beginnings, it is today a world-class facility with fantastic equipment that has served thousands upon thousands of children. And in the run-up to what I prepared for tonight, I went to see Tan Sri Jeyaratnam. And Tan Sri personally asked me to convey this to you. If, I'm sorry. If it wasn't for you, Julia, and the support that you gave to my father and Tan Sri, this would not have happened. Absolutely not. And Tan Sri wanted me to convey to you personally his thanks and gratefulness for you and what you did for him by inspiring him. Julia, we are so proud of you. And we know that this good work that you've done for just in the little case of Malaysia is going to go on from strength to strength.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Now we're going to move around the world here because I'm joined by two very special people. We have Enrique Fontes and, of course, Variety's own Jack Cannons. I'm going to ask, first of all, Enrique, tell us something about Beauty with a Purpose in Brazil.
Under the flag of Beauty with a Purpose, we have between 150 and 200 social projects created or supported under the flag of Beauty with a Purpose every year. So when Julia Morley brought the concept of Beauty with a Purpose to life, she gave real meaning to beauty pageants, and we only have to thank her for that.
Wonderful. Thank you, Enrique.
Thank you.
And it deserves a round of applause. You know, many of the people here have traveled from all the corners of the globe, and I know you've especially flown from Rio to Jersey just to be here tonight. And we have, so thank you for doing that. And also, Jack, you've come a long way. Where have you come from?
G'day, Steve. I've come from G'day. Sydney, from Sydney, Australia. And g'day, Julia.
It's nice. He's really wanted to speak to Julia, not the rest of us. But Jack, why don't you tell us a little bit about your relationship and how you've, in the past, been working with Julia?
Oh, I've had some wonderful experiences, and I'd need an hour to tell them all. But only a few years ago, I called on Julia and the team, the Miss World team, to come down to Australia to support our Variety Bash, which raises a lot of money in the centre of Australia. A long way to come. Julia never let us down. She turned up and brought with her a wonderful media team, which not only supported the Miss World team, but also Variety. On another occasion, I called on Julia and the team to come down for a Bush to Beach program, an Aboriginal program. Julia, again, didn't let us down. Came down, played with the kids. It was a wonderful, wonderful day. When I was CEO of Variety International, we didn't have a lot of funds. I needed computers, I needed websites. We couldn't fund them. Julia paid for those personally. It was amazing. And just to share one last thing, I know there's a tight schedule. Last year in Australia, 2015, the Miss World team raised $280,000 for Variety.
Wow. Well, that's it from Brazil and Australia. And now I believe we're going back to Angela.
One of the biggest success stories that Beauty with a Purpose has seen is in Kenya. This project alone has reached over 1.5 million people in Kenya. Can you believe it? Take a look.
In 2005, Miss World Kenya, Cecilia Mwangi brought to the world's attention the plight of many rural Kenyans and their daily battle with the jigger epidemic affecting millions of people.
We have like 2.6 million people jigger infested in Kenya, and it's affecting young children. You can see this is an age bracket. You can see they're all very, very old people and the very young people who are jigger infested. So we are trying to cure this problem by giving them medication. Plus we go to their homes, we fumigate their homes, and thereafter we have a follow-up program where at least we make sure we rehabilitate them and get back to school and carry on with education like the rest of these children.
Realizing that this was an opportunity where she could help, Julia Morley and Beauty with a Purpose got squarely behind Cecilia and lent their support and financial aid to the anti-jigger campaign.
Just being here, you can feel the energy. It's absolutely amazing, and it's something that, you know, the people just wanting to help in every way, it's truly inspirational.
So. Julia Morley and the Beauty Queens don't just come and take part in the ceremony. They actually come and really, really help the people here. That is the Beauty with the Purpose complete motto, is to really get in and help the people here in a really meaningful way.
Julia and the Beauty with a Purpose team have subsequently made multiple visits to Kenya and donated time, resources, and money to the project.
Young people, I'm so proud of you, and I will be back and I will do all I can to help you in your quest.
Each successive Miss World Kenya has been passed the responsibility of continuing the fight to eradicate this epidemic.
With education and awareness, we can eradicate some of these ridiculous afflictions that cause so much pain. Imagine, with a little bit of disinfectant and water and a clean home, we can eradicate the jigger.
The continuing support from Julia Morley and Beauty with a Purpose means that Kenya is on target to eradicate the jigger epidemic by 2019.
People of Kenya, we will help you. We're standing by you.
The lady that masterminded this campaign, Cecilia Mwangi, is joined with Miss World 2010, Alexandria Mills. Hello, ladies. Alexandria, would you like to join me over here? Okay, so Alexandria, how was it for you during your reign as Miss World to see this happening in Kenya?
You know, when you wear the crown, as you know, and all of the ladies at this table, the children come running immediately. And they're so excited to see you and know that, you know, it's a good thing that you're here. These children didn't have the energy. I'm sorry, I'm like shaking. I haven't actually like spoken about this in a really long time. Something that we take for granted, as simple as soap and water, can fix all of that.
We had such a great time in Kenya, and this young lady, when she came to see me in China, she said, you know, I didn't have anything for my Beauty with a Purpose. And she said, I feel so bad, but I'm going home, and I'm going to find something that you're going to be proud of. And I said, you do that, and I'll come to Kenya and support you. And believe it or not, this young lady, she's just incredible. I really want her to tell you. And I love this lady. I love her because she's emotional, because she cares. And she's come all the way from the United States, I've just discovered, to be here tonight with us. And she'll always be the same, a loving, warm, beautiful person to work with, especially with the kids, because they all love her. She's a good girl. But please let Cecilia tell you what she really has done.
Thank you, Julia. Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The anti-jigger campaign started in 2007. And it's because I went out to the village and saw this one thing that we have in the urban that was lacking in the rural: water. And I found out that so many kids, about 1.2 million children, were unable to go to school, to play, just like any other kid, because of jigger infestation. And jigger infestation is because they lacked water to wash their feet, because they are prioritizing water to drink. So Beauty with a Purpose has impacted on them in that it has raised their plight, their awareness globally. And to date, we have a success rate of about 50% of these children have gone back to school. They are wearing shoes. Thank you. We have rehabilitated their homes, because most of these cases of jiga infestation are poverty related. So we are empowering their parents to earn a living so that they're able to cater for their family. Through Beauty with a Purpose, their lives have transformed. And to date, I'm still going on with the anti-jiga campaign, and I'm on the prevention stage, and I'm looking towards all the children in Kenya going to school in shoes. Yes. Thank you very much. Thank you, Julia. And we're looking forward to hosting you. Thank you.
Julia, will you be going back to Kenya?
I'm really looking forward to seeing all of you in Kenya next month. Yes, we're going to be there.
I've documented all this for you and all the progress, and we've written a book, A Jigged Mind. Thank you. Thank you.
I want to speak a little bit to Bradley and Julia right now, if that's okay. Bradley, you've been awfully quiet.
Well, it's unlike me, to be fair. But I'm just watching a lot of the films that are going on now, and I wanted to ask you, Julia. I mean, you and I have known each other quite a few years now, and I don't spend a lot of time with the Miss World organisation, but we do the odd function together. In 1971, did you imagine that you would have, when you started Beauty with a Purpose, do you imagine the impact it would have thus far? I mean, it's extraordinary. Everyone's come up and they've been eulogising, et cetera, et cetera. And did you think you'd have that impact? Did you think it'd be a 3-5-year project, or did you think it was going to be as global as it is?
No, I didn't really think like that at all. I was in Singapore, and I was watching, I was working on a charitable project with Miss World, and I was watching an old lady, actually. She was each day on the streets early in the morning. She was very old, but in those days, before Prime Minister Lee came on board, it was very poor, and the children were all over the streets begging. And I watched her go each day and wash the children and give them food. And I went down one morning and I was talking with her, and then I asked her a question which I regret, and yet it stayed with me for the rest of my life. I said to her, "Don't you get tired of just washing the faces and giving these little kids food? You know, where is it going from there?" And she looked at me, I was very young, and she had a lot of wisdom, and she said, "Is it not better to light one candle in the darkness than not to see at all?" And it made me think a lot. She was so simple, and she wasn't annoyed with me. She just said that and smiled as much as, which put me in my place straight away and made me realize, you know, she was doing her bit. And why not use that beauty with a purpose and make it a purpose for the rest of our lives? Because for a woman to be working with beautiful women, what more can you do for young women than to encourage them to be useful in their hometowns and in their countries? So that's where it started, and it grew and it grew. I didn't know what it was going to do. I haven't done this, they've done it. I've just been the very lucky person at the top of the pile, if you like, being able to ask them, "Please, if you want to come into our contest, look around you first and find a useful purpose, and then let me know what you've done." So really, that's how it started, and that's how it's continuing.
We can see and we can feel Julia's heart so soft and her voice so strong as she touches the hearts and minds of men and women all around the world. And one such special friend, another surprise for Julia, is here tonight. He is Nelson Mandela's grandson. Please welcome from South Africa, Chief Mandela.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, Julia Morley, distinguished guests, children from around the world. Let me take this opportunity. For me, it gives me great pleasure to be here at the Variety Humanitarian Awards. Allow me at this outset to thank the organizers for inviting me to this auspicious occasion. My grandfather and our global icon, Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela, once remarked that There can be no keener revelation of a society's soul than the way in which it treats its children. Today, we salute a woman of tremendous soul and character, Julia Morley. You encourage us to do all in our ability and to raise our voices and our fellow human beings. Through your hearts, the orphans, the destitute, and the deprived can once more restore their hope and faith in humanity and in the possibility of a new dawn, a new society, and a new world where we once again realize the value of being each other's keepers. Julia Morley, you continue inspiring us, inspiring young women all across the world to do good to the world we live in. And thank you. We congratulate you. Thank you.
But that's not all. So many projects and countless countries. Beauty with a Purpose has touched so many. And there's another country, a hugely populated and rich country of culture and diversity that has been touched so much by Miss World. It shares a very, very special bond with Miss World, and that is India. Let's take a look at India.
Well, Beauty with a Purpose was created by Julia Morley more than 30 years ago. It has become globally recognized for its outstanding contribution to support those most in need. The hundreds and millions of dollars raised have changed the lives of sick and disadvantaged children in every continent. I've had the privilege of working alongside Mrs. Julia Morley as she traveled the world in support of these children who needed the most help. She's truly an angel on earth.
20 years ago, one of the most successful Miss Worlds ever was crowned, Aishwarya Rai. To begin her reign as Miss World, Aishwarya came home to a tumultuous welcome. It wasn't just that she was beautiful. Aishwarya was committed to her humanitarian role and was very involved in helping those less fortunate. On one occasion, traveling to Colombia to highlight the educational work being done with children of local coal miners, Aishwarya Rai is the embodiment of Miss World and Beauty with a Purpose. She has established herself as a leading contemporary actress of Indian cinema and has become one of Bollywood's most successful performers.
You know, to you all, it may sound like a motto, but genuinely, we get the opportunity as title holders to wear the crown. We get the opportunity to be the face of the purpose and to deliver truly under the able guidance and the quiet channeling of this very positive energy through Julia. So truly, I can't thank you enough for having had this experience so early and to be able to continue it all through my life, still ongoing, and miles to go before I sleep.
Please welcome with me Natasha Grover from the Indian Times and the brand new, just crowned Miss India and Mr. India.
Jen, we really request you to come here with us because I want to say this. I mean, we don't get this opportunity again and again in our lives. So I want to say this on behalf of the Times of India Group and Mr. Vineet Jain. This is a small token of appreciation because we're going to be putting this up as the headline tomorrow, where all our papers back in our country is going to carry. This is a very small thing to what you've done and contributed to this world and to our world. Thank you so much for everything, Jen. Thank you. We love you.
Wow.
Thank you for helping the thousands of children back in our country. You know, it's not in my script to say this, but you've really helped the children in a holistic manner. And Muktangan, Priyadarshini, the police project that you did with Diana Hayden, I think all of that is just an example of your kindness. Thank you for being kind, Jen.
Thank you, Natasha. Thank you.
Thank you.
And Natasha, if you will present this officially to... I'll take your mic. If you will present this to Julia, this is the front page of the Times of India tomorrow. So what a wonderful ceremony you're all witnessing today. Ladies and gentlemen, what a beautiful gift from India for the beautiful gifts that Julia has given to the world. Please.
Literally, the picture being taken by the photographer behind me now is going to be the picture that appears tomorrow on the front page of the Times of India. I think history is being made here with that. But you know, we have a great family here with us this evening, but not everyone could be here. And a very special member of our family is not able to be with us because they're not in the best of health at the moment. But we didn't want them to not share this evening, and they wanted to be a part of this evening. So if you look to the screens, there's a very special message from Sir Bruce Forsyth and Lady Winnelia Forsyth.
Hello, Julia. Sorry we cannot be with you on this very special occasion, but we send you all our love and many congratulations. You have been a great friend and a mentor to me, and you have changed many people's lives.
Including mine. I mean, you were responsible, or partly responsible, for me meeting, falling in love, and marrying the girl of my dreams, the most beautiful girl in the world, Winnelia.
So once again, congrats to you.
Who else but you could do what you do? Julia, you're lovely. Made of love.
I'm here with Dr. Ben Frederick, and when people ask me what was my most unforgettable experience as Miss World, it really would have to be my trip to Haiti with you and with Julia. And you had a big water project in Haiti, but other things happened while we were there.
Yeah, as was just mentioned, there was an accident that occurred. And I think there'll be a video about that. Should we take a look at that now then?
One of my first trips as Miss World was to visit Haiti and to see an orphanage, and these kids had their home displaced during the earthquake. When we got there, we went up the stairs and the kids wanted to say hello, so they all came rushing towards us. And in a matter of seconds, we just fell through the floor, from the second floor to the first. And you could see kids just running out.
You know, I mean, at one moment you're greeting these kids, you're all happy, they're happy, and then the next second, you know, you're falling down. I mean, you don't even know what to do, you're all in shock. And I think it's more of a reason for us to reach out and to help them and what they need. I mean, it's not just here in Haiti, it's all over the world. We were all affected by it, but Mrs. Morley is the one that's in the most critical condition. She's the spearhead of this all. I mean, she pours her heart into what she does with Beauty with a Purpose, and that's all she thinks about.
You know, a couple of years have passed since this has happened, but it's still very difficult for me to even watch the footage here. And Dr. Ben, would you like to tell everyone else more about the experience that we had?
Yeah, it really was a terrifying moment for all of us when I received the phone call from Steve that the balcony in the orphanage had collapsed and all of the children had fallen and the entire Miss World team had gone down with the fall. But it was clear that of all the different kinds of injuries, Julia's was the most severe. I had the opportunity to ride in the ambulance with her, and that's where I'd like to show you just a little bit about, tell you a little bit about her incredible grace and strength, which came through pretty amazing. This was an ambulance, but it really wasn't the kind of ambulance you're thinking of. It was more like a truck with a cab on it and a couple of stretchers. Julie hadn't been given any medication. It turned out her hip had been broken, but we didn't know that at the time. We just knew something very bad had happened, and she was in a tremendous amount of pain. Each time the truck hit a bump, it would jolt her hip, and she'd be in extraordinary amount of pain. But despite that, she maintained her composure, and even more to the to the point of her grace and her strength. Down between the two beds and the truck, there was a young boy who had fallen in the accident and had broken his knee, and that was pretty clear. Even on the truck ride, she kept reaching over to him with her hand and touching him and trying to comfort him and tell him that it would be okay. When we finally got to the hospital, the same thing in the emergency department, which was incredibly busy, hot. It was a rough environment and, again, very anxiety-provoking situation because Haiti just doesn't have the kind of care that you would want to have this injury in. She was in a gurney right next to him again, and she reached out and grabbed his hand and kept reassuring him that it would be okay, it would be okay. She was flown out of Haiti. She was evacuated by helicopter because her injuries were so severe they couldn't be managed in Haiti. What I think is incredible, though the story isn't ended, because within about 6 months after rehabilitation, she flew back to Haiti. And of course, you went with our team on that, Megan. You know, I've been to Haiti a number of times, and if that had happened to me, there's no way I would have gone back to Haiti. I wouldn't have stepped foot there. But she stepped back with a bit of a limp, but it didn't stop her. It didn't slow her down one bit. And one of the first things she did when she got to Haiti was go and visit that boy who had fallen and injured and gave him a big hug. So she demonstrates for me over and over again the strength and beauty and grace that she embodies through her organization. So to Julia, I want to thank you for the strength that you have, for the strength that you give me to do the kind of work that I do, and for the inspiration that you are to me personally and to all of us. So thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Ben. Now, moving on, we go to a country close to my heart, my hometown, home country, the Philippines. Now, in the Philippines, a problem that we are facing now is the increasing number of street children. But thankfully, we have Father Rocky, who is the candlelight to their darkness.
Beauty with a purpose deserves to be placed on a pedestal. And there is no one I could think of that deserves this recognition other than our dear Julia Morley, a woman of character and vision. Her advocacy syncs with ours for our Tuloy girls and boys ages 8 to 18 years old, regaining self-respect and dreaming for a better future through employable skills taught in our technician courses. Furthermore, we have the performing arts that develops their self-confidence and self-discovery of talents that they were never aware of. Julia, the children will perform as a tribute to you, and most of all, an expression of their gratitude for all your assistance and inspiration.
Tomorrow comes, I'll be on my own, feeling fat enough, the things that I don't know. When tomorrow comes,
you will be pleased to know that three kids will be joining a ballet competition in Hong Kong's Grand Prix, and two will be joining the summer ballet in Covent Garden in London this July. Seeing how the poor and abandoned orphan children can rebuild themselves for a bright future ahead. This is made possible by people who care like yourselves, Miss Julia Morley. Thank you so much, and God bless you all.
Ladies and gentlemen, joining me on stage is Cory Carino, the National Director of Miss World Philippines, and the one who has introduced Father Rocky to both, Julia and I both. But we have another story to tell this time. Back in 2011, while Julia and Alexander were visiting the Philippines, something happened in Philippine General Hospital. Mm-hmm.
Actually, it was the very first visit of Julia Morley to the Philippines. And I asked her, Julia, what would you like to do in the Philippines? And she said, I thought I would have to, you know, lay out the red carpet and bring out everything, the champagne and everything else. And then she said, no, Cory, I want to visit all the poor charity wards in all the poor hospitals in the Philippines. And then I said, Julia, that's a lot. And so we brought her to one of the poorest hospitals. We visited a charity ward. And as we were doing the rounds, I couldn't pull Julia away from this mother who had a one-year-old child who was actually dying and needed urgently an open heart surgery. And Julia came up to me and then she said, I can't think, I can't sleep, I won't be able to unless we do something about this child. We have to save her. Now, it isn't a coincidence that the name of this child is Sunshine. It is actually symbolic of who Julia is. She brings sunshine into the lives of needy children. And this is the same mandate she gives all of us as license holders to spread the sunshine.
Well, Julia, we tried looking for sunshine, and so please watch this.
Julia, you have taught us to use our lives more dramatically in other people's lives who need our help. Because of you, sunshine is a new lease on life. And now we have the hematology and oncology ward for terminally ill, cancer-stricken children at Philippine General Hospital. This is truly Beauty with a Purpose.
Because of the Beauty with a Purpose, my daughter, baby Sunshine, has a new life and a new heart. Thank you, Ms. Julia Morley, and we love you.
Thank you, Mommy Julia, for my new heart. I love you.
With the help of Cory and people back in the Philippines, even though we thought it couldn't be possible, we made it happen. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the UK, Maricel and her daughter, Sunshine.
I would just like to say that, Cory, thank you very much. Father Rocky he's my hero. He is such a warm, gentle person. He slept on the streets with the children to learn about them. He took them in, first a small group, and they built their home and their church with the small rocks representing children. He is the most incredible human being I know. And if you could go and take a chance to see Father Rocky in Philippines, you would be so grateful that this guy is on this earth. But for me, it's a great honor and privilege to meet Sunshine and her mummy, because she's worth it, don't you think so?
Yeah.
And
she's
definitely... This little girl is definitely our future, and she has the right So we are very proud to have her in England. And thank you, especially Jersey, because it's a beautiful place. But please, please stay and enjoy yourselves. And little Sunshine one day will come back and see us. Mm-hmm. And your mummy has been an amazing mother. She's fought for her daughter. That's how we met.
Yes.
And I'm so happy to see her.
We love you.
And a big thank you to Corey for coming all the way over with Mummy to make this possible. Now I'm going to invite to the stage to give his own personal tribute to both Julia and to Sunshine, Mr. Roderick Dixon.
Salutes the Beauty with the Purpose program.
What a job is being done by the Miss World organization.
The world. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the 75th Humanitarian Award is Julia Morley.
Julia, we are so proud to be in your company. We love you with all our heart, all of us, everybody in this room.
You know, thank you so much. It means a lot to have the presidents of Variety, the International Children's Charity, to be alongside me, because they always have been, and we always will be together as a group, because Variety has inspired me, my husband, my children, and I can't imagine life without you all. You're a family, we are a big family across the world, and with Beauty with a Purpose and Variety International, we go from strength to strength alongside each other, both doing their own thing, but sharing where we can. And I really mean it, that this has been an amazing experience tonight. I didn't expect it. I'd been holed up for 3 days. No one would talk to me, and I didn't know why. And it's such a like a dream for me tonight, so it means a lot. I don't like that. You're right. And to have this little one represent us all tonight, I think, is like our little Catherine Variety Sheridan when she was first in the hands of show business people. And we hope that we can all continue the same. God bless you, and thank you very much, all of you.
Join us next year for the 76th Humanitarian Award, wherever it may be. And thank you and good night from the Royal Showground here in Jersey.